Hello everyone. So last class we have solved one problem on frame. So that is non-stray frame. Let us solve one more problem on frame. So as we discussed last class, we need to first identify whether the frame is subjected to sway or it is non-sway. So as we discussed, so if there is a horizontal reaction due to the support condition at the beam level, if it is there, then it is non-sway. Then if it is not there, then you need to check for those conditions, whatever we have discussed, that is unsymmetrical geometry, unsymmetrical loading, and different end conditions, different moment of inertia of columns, then horizontal loading. Okay, so here total 1 2 3 4 four spans are there, A to B, B to C, C to E, and C D. Okay, EI is constant, they have given. So now first we need to identify whether it is sway or non. So this is beam level. Yes, there is a hinge support. So this hinge support will be having one horizontal reaction. So this horizontal reaction will not allow the frame to sway. So this is a problem of non-sway frame. Correct? So this is non-sway frame. So for non-sway frame, the procedure is same as beams. Okay, so let us solve this. Step one, so as usual, you will be finding the fixed end moments, MFAB, MFBA, MFBC, MFCB, MFCE, MFEC, MFCD, and MFTC. Okay, so A to B. So always remember, when you are finding the fixed end moment, so you need to stand inside the frame and you need to look each member. So this is AB member, the column. So load is acting rightward direction. Opposite to that, you need to look like this. Okay, this is anti-clockwise, this is clockwise. Similarly, this BC member. So on CE, there is no column, need not to worry. Okay, so this is minus WL square by 12 plus WL square by 12 BC minus WL by 8 plus WL by 8. Concentrated at the center. Again, it is UDL minus WL square by 12 plus WL square by 12. MFDC, CD, both are zero because there is no load on the column. Okay. So now, once you find the fixture moments, yeah, let me write these values quickly. So MFAB, after substitution, you will be getting so minus 26.67 minus 26.67 kilonewton meter. MFBA, it is plus 26.67 kilonewton meter. MFBC, it is minus 60. MFCB, it is plus 60. Kilonewton meter, kilonewton meter. And MFCE, it is minus 40 kilonewton meter. This is plus 40 kilonewton meter. Okay. So once you get this fixture moment, so as usual, second step, you need to find the rotation factor. Correct. So let me rub this. Step two, you will be finding rotation factor. Okay, similar to distribution factor. So you will be finding this rotation factor at the intermediate joints or support. Okay. So how many intermediate joints are there here? So joint B is an intermediate joint because it is associated with two members. Joint C, yes, it is associated with three members. Okay. So two intermediate joints. So as usual, we'll be drawing the tabular column to find the rotation factor joint member relative stiffness, summation of relative stiffness, then rotation factor minus 0.5 times distribution factor, that is K divided by summation of K. So two intermediate joints, joint B, okay, and joint C. With respect to joint B, there are two members, B2A and B2C, BA, BC. With respect to C, three members, CB, CE, and CD. CB, CE, and CD. So again, relative stiffness with respect to a joint, if the neck support is simple roller or hinged, 3/4 of I by L. If it is fixed and continuous, it is I by L. So at B, with respect to B, A is fixed. So it is I by L. So I is constant. So it is I by, span is 4 meters for BA. With respect to B, C is continuous. So when you will be considering it as a continuous, so after that, if the support is there, okay, after C, there is a support. If you consider this side, after C, there is a support. If support is there next to that particular joint, then it is continuous. If not, then it is the last support. Okay, here, there is a support, so it is continuous. If it is continuous, I by L. So it is I by, which is span is 6 meters. With respect to C, B is again continuous because after B, support A is there. So it is a continuation, C, B, A. This member is continued. Okay. So when it continued, there should be a support. If it is there, then it is continuous. If support is not there, then we will not consider it as a continuous. Okay. So with respect to C, B is continuous. Again, I by L, I by 6. With respect to C, E is again hinged. So they have given it as it is hinged support. So if it is hinged, the last support, then it should be 3/4 of I by L. So 3 by 4, I by L is 4 meter. With respect to C, D is again hinged. So if it is hinged, again, I by L. So it is I by 4 meters again. Okay. So these are the relative stiffness. Then at a joint, you will be finding summation of K, this plus this. This plus this plus this plus here. So if you calculate that, you will be getting 0.416i. 0.416i. Similarly, here you will be getting 0.542i. 0.542i. So this is 0.416i. So here it is 0.542i. So then relative stiffness minus 0.5 times K divided by summation of K, that is rotation factor. Sorry. So rotation factor, if you calculate, you will be getting this is minus 0.3, this is minus 0.2, CB it is minus 0.15, CE it is minus 0.175. Minus 0.175, and similarly CD it is also minus 0.175. Minus 0.175. Okay, so minus 0.175, it is minus 0.175. Okay, so as you are aware, at a joint this rotation factor should be minus 0.5. Add them, you will be getting. So here also it should be minus 0.5. Okay. So once you get this rotation factor, then third step, that is iterative table and Kani's boxes, with the help you'll be finding the rotation moments. Okay, so let me draw this here. Yeah, I'm sorry, it will, I'll rub this. This is A, B, C, E, and this is D. Okay, so this is step number 3, iteration table or iterative table by drawing Kani's boxes, and ultimately you'll be finding the rotation moments. Okay, so joint B is intermediate joint. I have drawn the Kani's box, two square boxes. Joint C, again Kani's box, so column. So this is BA member, BC member, CD member, and C member, as usual, like previous problem how we discussed, the same thing. So you'll be writing the fixed moments and rotation factor. So, and you will be calculating summation of fixed moment at the joint. Okay, so left hand side you will be writing the fixed moments, because near to the load you are writing. So MFAB, it is minus 26.67. MFBA, it is plus 26.67. MFBC, it is minus 60. MFCB, it is plus 60. MFCE, it is minus 40, and MFEC, it is plus 40. MFCD, it is 0, and DC is also 0. Okay, so these are fixed moments written near to the joints or the supports. Then we'll be writing the rotation factor. This is 0.3. B to A, B to C, it is 0.2, and C to B, it is minus 0.15, and C to D, it is minus 0.175. This is also minus 0.175. C to E, minus 0.175. This is also minus 0.175. Okay, C to D, C to E, rotation factor. If suppose it is multi-story building frame, then here also one column. So you'll be writing the rotation factor here. Okay. So once you write this, then you need to write these things: fixed moment at a joint. Before writing that, so first you need to check the last support. A support is last support. It is fixed. Here it is hinge. Here also it is hinge. Correct? So now, if the last support is simple roller or hinge, then moment about that particular support will be directly zero. Okay, those are the final moments. So here, hinge is there here. So moment is not the fixed moment. Need not worry, it is already zero. So here, yes, MFEC is 40, but it is hinged. We know if the last support is hinged, then moment is zero. I need to make the moment at E as zero. Okay, so we need to release that particular joint. Ultimately, you are making zero. So by adding minus 40. So ultimately it will be 0. So this is only final moment. Okay. So how much you have added? So in that 50% you should carry over to the next support. Correct? So with the same sign. This is minus. Now here minus 40 already it is there. From this it has minus 20 has come. So total minus 60. Okay. So now here need not worry, it is fixed support. Now fixed end moment, summation of fixed moment at a joint. So this plus this, this and this, you'll be writing it here. Okay, 26.67 minus 60. So it is minus 33.33, minus 33.33. So similarly here at C, plus 60, minus 60 and 0. So plus 60, minus 60 and here it is 0. So ultimately you will be getting 0 here. The summation of fixed moment at a joint here it is 0. So once you write this, then you need to find a rotation moments. Okay, at joint B and at joint C. So let me write it here. Rotation moment is equal to rotation factor into summation of fixed end moment at a joint plus far end rotation moments. Okay. Rotation moments at an intermediate joint you'll be finding M dash BA, B to A, M dash B to C, from B to C. Similarly, M dash C to B, M dash C to B, M dash C to E, M dash C to D. Okay, these all rotation moments you need to find at the intermediate joint. Total 5. BA, BC, CB, CD, CE. Okay, so at joint B 2, at joint C 3. Total 5 rotation moments. So this is trial 1. Okay, so first trial. So start with usual procedure. M dash BA for BA member. Okay. Rotation factor. It is minus 0.3. Minus 0.3. Summation of fixed moment at a joint. Minus 33.33. Minus 33.33. Summation of far end rotation moments. With respect to joint B, the far ends are A and C. So from here, nothing. From here, nothing. This is first trial. Okay. No value is there from far ends. So it is 0. Simplify this, you will be getting 10 kilonewton meter. So once you find, you will be writing it here. Okay. So M dash BC, B to C, same rotation factor minus 0.2. Summation of fixed moment at a joint minus 33.33. Plus again, far ends from B, this and this, it is 0. Simplify, you will be getting 6.67. 6.67 kilonewton meter. So now come to joint C. So I'll rub this. Okay, so this is, we got 6.67. So this is initial, I have considered 0. Now it will come. Okay, so C to B, rotation factor minus 0.15. Minus 0.15. Summation of fixed moment at a joint is 0. Plus far end rotation moments. With respect to C, the far ends are B here. Okay, then here and here. From E, nothing is there. From D, nothing is there. And from B. So yes, from trial number 1, the value had come here. So the same value you need to consider here. That is 6.67. So if you add this, okay, you will be getting minus 1.0. This is minus 1.0. So means it is minus 1.0, minus 1. Okay. Similarly, with respect to CE, you are writing rotation factor minus 0.175, minus 0.175. summation at a fixed moment 0, then far ends again 6.67 plus 0 plus 0. So add it, you will be getting only 6.67. So simply for this, you will be getting 1 minus 1.17. Minus 1.17. So last one, M dash D2, C2D, M dash CD. So rotation factor minus 0.175, fixed moment at adjoint 0 plus, again with respect to C, far ends are this, this and this. 6.67 plus 0 plus 0. Again, it is 6.67. Same like this. You will be getting minus 1.17. So, you will be writing it here below the box, right hand side. Okay, minus 1.17. This is minus 1.17. CE here, CD here. Okay, this is trial number 1. Then, you will continue with the same procedure like how we had in case of beams or the previous problem in frame. So same thing, continue. So only these values will be changing. Okay, so these values, this side, they will be changing. So second trial. So now M dash B to A, you are writing. So rotation factor will remain same, fixed moment at a joint will be same, this and this. Then summation of far end rotation moments, from A it is 0, from C it is minus 1, you will substitute over there. Okay, similarly for BC, only far end rotation moments with C, so second value whatever come, so that is, you need to write it. So from B to A you are writing, so minus 1 only, for here also, this is minus 1, this is minus 1. Okay, so whatever the value will come here, that will be considered here. Whatever the value you are getting here, that will be considered here, here and here. So you will be getting some values here. Okay, so I hope you know the procedure. So let me write this rotation moments values directly. Okay, once you continue with that, so you will be getting in second trial, this is 10.3, this is 10.31 in third trial. Here 6.87, third trial 6.87. Almost in third trial you are getting same values. This is minus 1.03, this is also minus 1.03. This is minus 1.20. Here also it is minus 1.20. Here minus 1.20, same thing. Minus 1.20, minus 1.20. Okay. So these are the final values you need to consider. These rotation moment values at the intermediate joint to calculate your next step. Final movements. Okay, so let me write that. Step number 4, final movements is equal to fixed end moment plus 2 times near end rotation moment plus far end rotation moment. Okay, so suppose if I write MAB, MAB, fixed moment MFAB minus 26.67, minus 26.67 plus 2 times near end rotation moment. A to B are writing, near end is this 0 plus far end, from A to far end is this, you will be considering this value, rotation moment 10.31. so 10.31, so MBA, B to A, fixed moment 26.67 plus 2 times, now near end rotation moment is this, far end is this. It will be there in the same span, B to A, A to B. So this is near end, far end is this. So 2 times 10.31, far end is 0. That is MBC, B to C. So now it is in the same span, BC. So near end is this, far end is this. So MFBC minus 60 plus 2 times near end, 6.87 plus far end, minus 1.03. So then next, MCB. Fixed moment 60 plus 2 times near end is this, minus 1.03. Far end is 6.87. So this value. Okay. So then next, MCE. Let me write MCE. So I will rub this. MCE. Fixed moment minus 40. Plus 2 times, it is in the same span. This is C, this is E. So this is near end, this is far end. Minus 1.20, far end, it is 0. Then MEC, fixed moment. So it is directly, do not apply any equation. Because last support, already we have made the moment at that particular support, 0. So only one is left, that is C2D. M, C, D. Okay. Fixed moment is nothing. Plus 2 times near end, minus 1.20, plus far end, it is 0. Correct? M, D, C. Fixed moment 0. Plus 2 times near end 0, plus far end it is minus 1.2, minus 1.2. Simplify this. These are the ultimate rotation moments to calculate the final moments. So once you simplify this, you will be getting MAB is minus 16.36 kilonewton meter, which is anti-clockwise since it is negative. So MBA 47.29 clockwise newton meter. MBC minus 47.29. Then MCV, it is 64.81. MCE, it is minus 62.40. MEC 0. MCD, it is minus 2.40 kilonewton meter. Then finally, MDC, you will be getting 0. So yes, I'm sorry. MDC, yeah, this is also 0. You need not to apply the equation. MDC, you should be written 0. Yeah. Do not apply the equation for these two. Do not apply the equation. Okay, because they are final moments. Okay, this was the problem. So this is hinged, this is hinged. Here also moment is 0. Here also moment is 0. Do not apply the equation. Okay, so once you get this, what you will be doing, you need to draw the bending moment diagram, that is actual bending moment diagram, and you'll be drawing the shear force diagram, elastic curve. So you'll be considering the frame. Okay, so first you'll put the brackets, then depending upon the values, you will mark them. Okay, whatever you are getting. Then, depending upon these arrows, you will be drawing the support moment diagram and free bending moment diagram depending upon the loading. So, whatever the loading has there, depending upon that, you will be drawing that. So like previous problem, what we have done, so similar fashion, you can draw the actual Venn diagram and shear force diagram. You will be considering entire beam as one. So here, here, here is C, right? ACB, ACE. Okay, then for column separately, this column separately, the reactions you will be finding. So what are the reactions? This, this, this. Similarly, you will be finding the reactions here. Nothing is there here, but moments are there. You will be getting this. Okay, so maybe shear force diagram will be getting like this. Okay, maybe here, this side, like this. Okay, maybe here some value, so you might be getting zero. Okay, just check with this. You can draw this like previous problem I had discussed how to draw. Similar fashion, you can draw this. Then elastic curve, you can draw. Okay, so this is with respect to non-sway frames. Okay, these are the frames which are ground floor, maybe one bay or two bay. Okay, so as we discussed in the first class, so this particular Kani's method is having the advantages with respect to multi-story building frames. Okay, so we can apply this particular method to solve the problems on frames with multi-story. Okay, so let us solve a few problems with multi-story building frames. Okay, let us consider the next problem. C, D, yeah, let us solve this problem. So very much important problem. In most of the question papers, you will be getting the problems with respect to Kani's method on frames that too like this. Okay, so as usual, so first you need to identify whether this particular frame is subjected to sway or non-sway. Okay, so first you will check at the beam level, is there any horizontal reaction developed due to support condition. So this is G plus one building frame, one bay. Okay, only column to column, only one is there. So one bay and G plus one building frame. So this is the beam level. At beam level, there is no reaction that is horizontal developed due to the support condition. If it is not there, then you need to go back to your those conditions, whatever we have discussed. So unsymmetrical geometry, unsymmetrical loading, different end conditions, moment of inertia of columns, different horizontal loading. If out of these five any one is present, then it is subjected to sway. Correct. So let me check. So if draw the center line of this, okay, exactly here. So this is total 6 meters. So 3 meters this side, 3 meters this side. So vertical axis. So this side and this side, the loadings are same. Even this loading is same. Even the geometry is also same. Total 8 meters, here also 8 meters. This side and this side, it is left out 3 meters, 3 meters. Even loading are equidistant. See, unsymmetrical geometry, it is not there. Unsymmetrical loading, it is also not there, because it is symmetrical loading UDL on entire span given this concentrated load at a distance 1 meter, at a distance 1 meter, okay, from the center axis. Correct. So unsymmetrical loading, it is not there. Horizontal loading, either at B, C, D, E, or either on the columns, no, that is also not there. Then different end conditions, yes, that is also not there. So both the conditions are fixed. Then moment of inertia of columns, so II, so that is also same. So means, so though there is no horizontal reaction developed due to the support condition at beam level, this particular problem so is not having any condition such that it is sway. Correct. So ultimately this is non-sway frame. This is non-sway frame. Okay. So here, if it is non-sway frame, then we are having four steps. Step one, you will be finding friction moment. Step two, rotation factor. Step three, iteration table using Carney's boxes, you will be finding rotation moments, then final moments. Correct. So step one, friction moments, it is okay. So step two, that is to find rotation factor. Okay, where you'll be finding, so at the intermediate joints. So how many intermediate joints are there here? So joint B, yes, it is an intermediate joint. Joint C, yes. Joint D, yes. Joint E, yes. Okay, so how many rotation factor you need to find? BA member, BE member, BC member, CB member, CD member, DC member, DE member, ED member, EB member, and EF member. Okay, so yes, you can find it. So then again, rotation moments. So using those iteration table. So here your Carney's boxes will be, so at the intermediate joints. So one at B, one more at C, then D, then E. So total four you need to draw. B, C, D, E. Those Carney's square boxes. Then you need to find rotation moments. Iteration table. So iteration, you need to do it. How many rotation moments in one trial you will be finding? M dash BA, M dash BC, M dash BE, M dash CB, M dash CD, M dash DC, M dash DE, M dash ED, M dash EB, and M dash EF. So if you do like this, so again the problem is simply increase in time, the calculation. Okay, so best way is, if you get such type of symmetrical loading non-sway frame, so then you can depend on one of the important parameter over here. So what is that? Since it is symmetrical about vertical axis, this side and this side, so relative stiffness, so you can directly make it half, then calculate the rotation moments and ultimately final moments. So exactly from the vertical axis, either on left hand side or on right hand side. So whatever the moments you are getting on left hand side, the same thing will be there on the right hand side. So ultimately it is symmetrical about vertical axis. This side and this side moments will be same. You should get same moments with opposite signs. So suppose final moment M may be, if you are getting 60 kilonewton meter clockwise, so MEF, it should be 60 kilonewton meters anti-clockwise. Okay, suppose here it is anti-clockwise, you should get here clockwise. So same magnitude but opposite direction, because it is symmetrical loading, symmetrical frame. Okay, only thing, the property what you need to take care is, that is relative stiffness. Instead of analyzing for the entire thing, so you are cutting this frame into only this and treating here it as fixed. Okay, if I draw that, it will be like this. I will be analyzing only this, cutting here exactly. So this portion, that is A, B, C, and this is entire thing. D is there, E is there, but I am cutting exactly at the center. Okay, only this portion. I will be finding the moments over here. Okay, instead of considering entire frame, I'll be using this symmetrical frame property. So because this side and this side about the vertical axis, moment will be same. Okay, so since I'm cutting these beams exactly at the center, even the relative stiffness I need to consider as half. This is k by 2, k by 2. Not entire k. So that is k by 2, k by 2. I need to consider. This you need to take care. So, but AB, it is full member you are considering. B2, C is also full member you are considering. That k is as it is. But for CD and BE, so exactly at the center you are cutting. So relative stiffness of that particular member, you need to make it half. And now, instead of this, you are analyzing only this. These are the intermediate joints. You will be drawing the Carney's boxes only here. You will be finding the rotation factor only here. Ultimately, you will be analyzing only this half portion. So other half portion, whatever the values you are getting, the same thing will be reflected on the other side of the members. Okay, so let me start with this. So step one, you will be finding the fixed moments. Step one, you will be finding the fixed moments. So MF AB equal to MF BA equal to MF BC MF CB. So even if you write this side, that is also all the values will be zero. Okay, since I am considering only this, I will be writing this, okay, which are equal. So BE and CD, yes, they are there. MF BE. So B to E, this is like entire thing. Okay, so loading you need to consider entire thing. Only relative stiffness you need to make it half. So fixed moment calculation is for the full member, not for the half member. So for the full member. So there are two concentrated loads. So like principle of superposition, how we have done in previous problem. For this WA B square by L square. For this WA B square by L square, that is MF BE. We need to write it. MF BE, right? Yes. MF BE for this 30 plus this 30. So if I write that, minus WA B square by L square, W is, okay, this must be equal to 30 into A. For B, it is 4 square by 6 square plus for this 30. 30, A is 4, B is 2 square by 6 square. Correct. So if you simplify this, you will be getting minus 40. This is minus 40 kilonewton meter. That is MF B to E. So one more friction moment I want, C to D. MF CD. That is UDL minus WL square by 12. So if you substitute the value, you will be getting minus 90. Minus 90. Kilonewton meter. So I want B to E, B to A, B to C. So this is 0, this is 0. So only B to E. Yes, I got it as minus 40. Then CB I want, but load is not there, 0. CD, UDL is there, that is minus 90. Okay, fixed end moment. But you will be considering fixed end moment for the entire span. Keep it in mind. Only thing, this, that is relative stiffness, you need to consider it as half, because you are cutting exactly at the center. Okay, so now once you find the fixed moments, then step two, that is rotation factor. Okay, so time being, I will rub this, so I will keep it this figure for my reference. Yeah, step two, rotation factor U. Okay, so this, by drawing that tabular column, joint member relative stiffness, summation of relative stiffness Then rotation factor u is equal to minus 0.5 times distribution factor k divided by summation of k. So now the intermediate joints are B and C. I'll be considering only this because ultimately I am analyzing only this joint B and joint C. Okay, with respect to B, the members BA, BE, BC. BA, BE, BC. With respect to C, CB and CD. CB and CD. Okay, so now with respect to B, the A support is fixed. Relative stiffness will be I by L. If it is fixed or continuous, it is I by L. With respect to B, A is fixed, it is I by L. So I is, yes, let me write those. This is I, this is I for CD beam and BE beam. Moment of inertia is given 2I. Okay, so B to A it is only I, so I by L. L for BA member, it is 4 meters. Yeah, it is 4 meters. So similarly, B to E. So now either you can consider it as fixed or continuous, both will do. Okay, so if exactly at the center you have cut, so after that there is a support, then there is a continuation also. Either if it you consider here only fixed or continuous, ultimately it is I by L. For B member, it is 2I. So 2I by L. For B member, length is 6. This is 6 meter BB. This is also 6 meter CD. It is 2I by L is 6. This is K. But we need to take care of this. How much is that? K by 2. K is for B member 2I by L. Okay. Though you are considering only half portion, L you need to consider for the entire member. Okay, only after calculation you need to make it half. This is K. Now it is 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. I am making this as relative stiffness as half, since I have cut exactly at the center. Similarly, B to C, it is continuous because after C there is a support that side. So I will consider it as I by L. L is 4. Then come to C joint. C to B, it is continuous because after B there is a support. So I by L, I by 4. With respect to C to D. So now again you can consider either fixed or continuous. Okay, it is I by L. So you need to consider K by 2. So for the entire member it is 2I by L is 6. But you are dividing by 2, the relative stiffness K by 2. So I have written 2I by 6 into 1 by 2. Okay, calculation of relative stiffness for the entire span. Okay, only thing, so you need to make that as half, since you are cutting exactly at the center. Okay, once you simplify this, you will be getting a summation 0.667I. So this at B 0.667I. At C, 0.417i. 0.417i. Okay, then rotation factor. So minus 0.5 times k divided by summation of k. So this by this into 0.5, you'll be getting minus 0.187. Minus 0.187. For BE, minus 0.125. Minus 0.125, then minus 0.187 for BC, minus 0.187 for BC. CB, minus 0.30, minus 0.30, this is minus 0.20. So ultimately at a joint, so you will be getting summation of fixed moment as minus 0.5. Okay, so once you find this rotation factor, then we need to go to step 3, that is to find a rotation moments by Carney's boxes, that is iteration procedure. Okay, so let me rub this. Yeah, step three. Iteration table. Okay, so by drawing Carney's boxes. Okay, so now this is my figure. I'll be considering half of the portion. So this is BA, joint B, there is a Carney's box. Okay. B to C, again a member. So again, there is a Carney's box. Okay, C to D. A member. This is cut portion. B to E member, a cut portion. Okay, like how the half portion we have considered, in similar fashion, I have drawn the Carney's boxes. Okay. So this is A, this is B, this is C, and this side it is D and E. Okay. So only these two boxes are sufficient to calculate the moments. So however, D and E, they are not the supports. So exactly at the beam we have cutting the section. Okay, so let me write the fixed moment. MAB it is 0, MBA it is 0, MBC it is 0, MCB it is 0, MCD it is minus 90, and MBE it is minus 40. Just now you have calculated MF C to D, MF B to E, MF CD, MF BE. These are the fixed moments. Okay, then rotation factors. So for BA member it is minus 0.187. So B to C it is minus 0.187. This side. C to E it is 0.125. Minus 0.125. So here it is minus 0.2 for CD. For CB it is 0.3, minus 0.3. So now fixed end moment at a joint. So this plus this plus this, MFBC, MFBA plus MFBE. So 0 plus 0 minus 40. So here ultimately you will be getting minus 40. Similarly here, MFCB plus MFCD, that is minus 90. So this plus this, that is minus 90. Okay, summation of fixed moment at a joint. Okay, so once you get this, then you will be finding the rotation moments. Rotation moment is equal to rotation factor summation of fixed moment at a joint plus summation of far end rotation moments. Okay, so which are the rotation moments you are finding? M dash BA, M dash BC, M dash BE. With respect to joint B, B to A, B to C, B to E. Similarly, M dash C to B and M dash C to D. C to B and C to D. So in trial number 1. So similarly, trial number 2, trial number 3, you do for both the joints to till you get the rotation moments in successive values same. Okay, so let me start with this trial number 1. M dash BA rotation factor minus 0.187, minus 0.187. fixed moment at a joint it is minus 40 plus far ends. With respect to B, the far ends A C and E. From here at least it is 0. From C to D when you are finding, that time also it is 0. So here also it is 0. Here also this is beginning step, it is 0. Okay. So from here 0, here 0, here 0. So ultimately it is 0 for trial number 1. So if you simplify this, you will be getting for BA 7.48. 7.48 kilonewton meter. Similarly, M dash B to C. So minus 0.187 minus 40 friction moment plus again Farrens from E, from C, from A, 0, 0, 0. Okay. So again, you should get 7.48 kilonewton meter. So that is for M dash B to C. So here I need to represent them, the rotation moments. P to A, I will be go on writing downwards. 7.48. B to C, it is 7.48. I will go on writing like this, upwards, one another, the other. So this is 7.48. Okay. So B to E. So rotation factor 1 to 5, friction moment Z. Then again 0 from far ends. This is trial number 1. So simply for this, you will be getting 5.0 kilometer meter. Then coming to joint C, M dash C to B. So rotation factor minus 0.3, friction meter joint minus 90 plus far ends. With respect to C, the far ends are here. That is near in the same span B to C, 7.48. Again from D, it is 0. So I need to consider this value, 7.48, which is from B. Far ends are from C are this and this. Rotation moments from here, it is 0. From here, it is 7.48. So yes, if I consider that 7.48, so you will be getting CB. It is 24.76 kilonewton meter. So I'll write it here, 24.76. Similarly, last M dash CD, rotation factor minus 0.2, friction moment 0, plus again, from here it is 7.48, from here it is 0, plus 7.48, you will be getting 16.50 kilonewton meter. Okay. So I hope you are familiar with this. Now, at least already we have solved so many problems on beams and frames. So this is trial 1. Similarly, you need to go on continuing this procedure, only these values will be changing. Correct? Yeah. These values will be changing. That is summation of far end rotation moments. Okay. So this. Okay. So once you do that, let me write directly the values what you'll be getting. Since you are familiar with this, since we have solved so many problems, you can calculate that. So you will be getting, this is 2.85 in second trial, 2.85, 2.60 in third trial, fourth trial 2.58. So here it is 5 in first trial we got. Let me write it here. Next one, 1.90. Second trial, third trial, 1.73. Fourth trial, 1.72. Here, second trial, 2.85. Third trial, 2.60. Fourth trial, 2.58. Okay. So actually the distance between C and B make it bigger such that this and this value will not be clashing. So here 24.76, this is 26.14. Then next 26.22. So I'll write it here 26.22. The next one 26.23. So here it is 16.50. Then 17.48. I'll write it here. 17.48. Then 17.48. First trial, second trial, third trial. So in four trial, almost, sorry. 2.58. Okay. In four trial, you will be getting the similar values. Okay. I hope you can do this. Okay. So once you get this rotations, so in even in examination, it's not necessary to write all the things. Okay. All the calculation you need not to show. So one trial or second trial, two trials you can show. Then rest of the things only far end rotation moments they will be changing. So you can do it in calculator and directly you can write this. Okay. So now last step, you need to find the final moments. So final moments. So final moments is given by fixed end moment plus 2 times near end rotation moment plus far end rotation moment. So MAB, if I find MAB, fixed end moment 0 plus 2 times near end, here rotation moment nothing is there, 0 plus far end, so this B, it will be in the same span. So it is 2.58. Okay. So if it is not clear, simplify this, you will be getting 2.58. This zero ultimately 2.58. Similarly, MBA, B to A. So fixed end moment 0 plus 2 times near end, it is 2.58, plus far end, this it is 0. Simplify this, 5.16 kilonewton meter, kilonewton meter. Then B to C, let me write MBC, B to C, fixed end moment 0 plus 2 times end rotation moment. B to C you are writing, so near end is 2.58, far end is this, that is 26.23. Simplify this, you will be getting 31.39 kilonewton meter. Then M's BE, let me write BE, fixed end moment minus 40 plus 2 times near end, it is 1.72. From far end, so here nothing, 0. Simplify this, you will be getting minus 36.56. Okay. Similarly, MAB, MBA, MBC, MCB. So next, here, that is joint C. Let me write it here. Okay, with respect to BR over AB, BA, BE, BC, BA, BE, BC. Now come to C. So let me write, this is not required now. MCB. So fixed end moment 0 plus 2 times near end 26.23, far end, that is 2.58. So C2D, MCD, fixed end moment minus 90 plus 2 time near end 17.48, far end it is 0. So if you simplify this, CB will be getting 55.04, and CD you are getting it as minus 55.04 kilonewton meter. 55.04 minus 55.04. AB 2.58, BA 5.16, BC 31.39, and BE it is minus 36.56 kilonewton meter. So these are the moments, okay, final moments what you have found by considering only half of the portion. Okay, so directly you can draw the figure and you can write the values. So let me write these values here. So let me draw this again so that you can understand. So we have considered only half portion, this portion, correct? We have cut a section here, we have cut a section here. So M maybe we got it as 2.58. So first let me put the brackets. Okay, MAB 2.58 clockwise. So clockwise means, so this side, this is 2.58. So MBA 5.16, B to A, again it is clockwise, 5.16. So MBC, B to C, it is 31.31 clockwise, B to C, this 31.39. Okay, then BE, B to E, it is minus 36.56. Minus means anti-clockwise. This is anti-clockwise. 36.56. Then at joint C, CB, it is 55.04. C to B, it is clockwise. Yes, 55.04. So then CD minus 55. So C to D minus 55. This is 55. Okay. So now you got the values on left side of the axis. That is when you are drawn exactly from the center. Okay. So now on the other side, on the other side of the frame, what will be the values? They will be in equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. Correct? So now let me consider entire frame, the symmetrical frame. Okay, so these values you have found, 36.56, 5.16, 2.58, 31.39, 55.04, and this is 55, same portion. So now this side, the same magnitude but opposite direction. This is clockwise. So let me draw this bracket first. This is clockwise. This side it should be anti-clockwise, means this side. This is 2.58. This is clockwise. This side should be anti-clockwise, 5.16 with same magnitude. This is anti-clockwise. This has to be clockwise. 36.56 clockwise, anti-clockwise, 31.39. This is anti-clockwise, is clockwise, this has to be anti-clockwise. This is anti-clockwise, this has to be clockwise, 55.04, same value. Okay, so directly you can write like this. We have considered only half of the frame and we have analyzed this particular problem. Okay. So now once you get this, all the moments, you will be drawing the actual bending moment diagram. Okay. So quickly let me draw here. Okay. So first let me draw the pre-bender diagram, that is depends on the loading. The loadings are there only on the beams. So here the loading is there on BE, that is concentrated loads, two concentrated loads. So here, so you'll be getting the bending moment diagram something like this, W into A, W into A. So that is 60 load is there. So here also 60, this is 60. So this is W into A, correct? So here also W into A. So here it is, UDL is there, WL square by 8. So that is 135. Only two loads are there. So now the support moment. So already have calculated positive and negative. So directly you can draw it. This is 2.58, 5.16. 2.58, 5.16. Thirty six point five six. Okay, here also it is 36.56. And then this 31.39. 31.39. So here it is 55.04. So more than this 55.04. And here it is also 55.04. This is more than that. This is also 55.04. Join this straight line. And here it is 135. WL square by 8. Okay. So this is your bending moment diagram. So we'll be writing positive, negative, inside positive, outside negative, right? This is plus. Okay. I hope it is clear. So usually in the examination point of view, this type of problems will come in the examination where they will be given the symmetrical frames. So non-sway frames, you need to analyze such type of frames that usually G plus one, okay, one way, sometimes two way. Okay. Next class, let us solve one more problem on such type of frame where I will be considering two way G plus one building frame. Okay. Symmetrical, non-sway. Okay. Thank you. Let me stop here. Thank you.